Okay, so I managed to get the frame rate and such up at displaying on this one. So let's continue on. This one is going to be a shorter game or video because it'll take so long to process this stuff when it's there. So let's see, what have we got? Items. So we're at 203. We can carry some. Where's Lydia? Have we emptied?
I've got your back.
Need to trade some items with you.
How can I serve you, my friend?
Okay. So she's fine. So we're going to go back. We're going to fast travel back to the mine. It's cleared, as it says. So let's do A. And then let's fast travel there. So we're going to go back in to here. Should be still be cleared. Not always, but often. If it says cleared, it will stay cleared. Oh, get stuck there. So we came through there. Let's do a quick scan of everything else, see if anything has changed. Well, we have, there's another axe finally, which we have. So, oh, and there is the mine. And I don't think anything's really changed. So let's go down in the mine, or the halted steam camp, and we're going to look around. Because I don't want to. That will trigger. That's bad. That will trigger that there. Now, come over here. Here's a shovel. There's a pickaxe. Now that's what we want because we can mine iron ore. So we're mining iron ore. Sort of boring to watch, but the advantage is this gives us a bunch of iron ore, which we can do things with. That would allow us to do that. Iron ore is depleted. So okay, and we come on down here. Harvest. We see another iron ore. So there's quite a few. There's quite a bit of iron ore here. And if you're the type who like you, this stuff will respawn if I believe it's like 2 weeks or something. I can't remember, but it does respawn after a period of time. So that's there. There's more iron ore. This is the rough way to get to the. So there's that. Now let's activate that trap because I don't like the traps hanging around. Mine, let's see. Iron ore vein. So we're going to mine some more iron ore. So I've been in a couple of my hard rock mines. I can't remember where, but they're just, it's amazing to see how people dug through things, did all that digging. So we come down here and we see some more iron ore. Interesting question. I wonder if anybody knows. I've never really looked up. What does anybody know what iron ore vein would actually look like? How accurate do they portray it in Skyrim? I mean, accuracy is not that important, for a video game, I guess. Look at combat and things like that. But, you know, we know that that's not terribly accurate. So, there's another iron ore vein. And see, we want to get... We're looking for money. So what we're going to do is we can use the transmute. So we've got several iron ore. So now then, if I take a look at my magic, under alteration, we have transmute. So if we have that as left and right, so we're going to... have a gold ore added. Okay. So, don't have enough magic. Okay. So let's get back our items. Let's get back our torch. Oh, we still could have sold some things. So now then. Let's take a look around here. Do we see any more? Surge the bandit. So do we see any more iron ore? And we do. And we're going to mine the iron ore. And I admit, this is kind of boring, but we're... that's interesting. Items, miscellaneous, torch. Okay, so we come on down here, and we see some more iron ore. Hey. Oh, and we picked up an amethyst. So, the ironing, you know, mining through here, you pick up a few other things. So we did that. And we see some more iron ore over here. We're going to keep... Ooh, interesting. All screwed up. Picked up an amethyst, but I'm not sure what we got in... What we got our head in, or the camera in. Oh, it's in the skull. There we go. So, now then. Okay, there's that. But we've already triggered that, I believe. So let's mine some more iron ore. I want to have lots of iron ore. It's a lot of work. It's slow... This is part of the slow stuff. This is doing the grinding, mining iron ore. And then let's get our items, miscellaneous torch back. So we want to see what else we got here. Let's set. So I trip the trap. And let's see if there's any more iron ore. Yeah, we're going to mine some more iron ore. Yeah, this is sort of boring. But we're accumulating a bit of iron ore. We're grinding, I guess is the phrase. So, is there any more to Skyrim? I don't want to go to Skyrim. Takes it back up there. See if we see any more iron ore. It does. Search the mammoth. We don't want the snout. Okay. Now, do I see any iron ore anywhere here? No. No, no. Yes, we do. We see some... Oh, that's... corundum. Now, what happens is that would allow us to create steel, because that's what supposedly it's corundum, and I believe an iron ore will let you create steel. So we have some corundum. And see if there's anything else around here. No. So now we start the entry. Now we start. And what this does is this transmute, this spell converts, it'll convert iron into silver and silver into gold. Don't have enough magic. So now then, let's do B, items, miscellaneous. Oh, we're going to pick up back up our weapon. A. Then we're going to switch. Okay, so we're going to do magic, alteration, transmute, left and right. So now we have gold ore. And what we can do, the forge. Okay, so we can, all right. So we don't have the smith to do that. Okay, so what we're going to do is, oh, there's some more iron ore. I somehow missed that. Let's get that little bit of iron ore. Iron ore vein is depleted. So, all right, let's do a quick check. Is there anything else in here? Anything else for us to smith? Oh, come on. There we go. Let's open Skyrim. We're getting 39 frames per second there. Okay, we're getting higher than 30. Let's do a quick check here if there's anything we're interested in. Not really. We could do some more. We could take another axe, but we don't need another axe. So let's go back. No, I see. Before we do that, let's do another silver ore added. So now we go back to Whiterun. And what we need is we're going to head over here.
Got some good pieces out here if you're looking to buy. Or inside.
To the smelter. As a smelter, okay, so that's there. What we can do is we could make, okay, so let's make a gold ingot. A. No, okay. So now then. So we added another gold ore. I need to wait for our magic to increase. It's one of the downsides. I haven't been working on the magic that much. So we need to create our, get our magic up. Don't have enough magic. Let's see where we need to get to. Don't have enough magic. So it takes us a minute. Now we have a silver ore. Now then, what have we, how much of this miscellaneous? So we have corundum ore, iron ore. We've got 37. Wow. Okay. So, but we do have a couple of, iron-studded imperial leather jewelry. So, we can increase, that increases it by 20%. This actually, in theory, increases by more, but I think because we don't have that great of salesmanship or speaking, you know, persuasion, we're just going to create. So we created the iron ingot. Now then, that gives us gold ore. Now, so we use the smelter. And let's create a gold ingot. So it takes two gold, requires two gold ore, and we have three. Now then, we're almost up to the point where we can cast another one. So wait a second. So, our alteration increased, so we have silver ore. But what we want to do is we want to need to do that one more time. So we have to, it takes the iron ore, converts it to silver ore, then we take it from silver ore and we convert it to gold ore. Then we make our gold ingot, and then we're going to make a necklace. So we do that, and we've now got a gold ore. So we can use the smelter now at this point to, what we're going to create is another gold ingot. Okay. So now we're out of gold ore. Okay. So now then, let's go back over here. Go back to jewelry. We can make a gold necklace. So we've got two gold ingots. So we make one there. And we've got two gold necklaces. So let's come back over. Now we've got enough. We have silver transmuted. So it's going to take us a little while to transmute. We've got a lot of transmuting to do. So while we're wandering along, we're going to watch our magic levels till they go up. And we're going to go into Bellathor's and let's start selling some things. Okay, talk to
everything's for sale, trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing.
So now then, I've heard, okay, so let's see what we don't want to sell the amethyst. We can sell the boots, the bowls. We're not getting much for that. Now we're going to get, okay, so the copper and ruby circlet, yes. Cups. Flute, goblet. See, we're only getting two, but they don't weigh that much. Now, gold necklace. Okay, so we're not gold ore, jugs, large antlers, yes. Long pick mammoth tusk. Now, we've already got, so that will, so we're nightshade, plate, platter, pot. Silver amethyst ring. Now we've already read that, so we can sell that. And the weak poison. So we've sold just about everything we could have there. So now then. B. So We're not quite, we haven't quite. Now then, somebody else said the something, wait a minute. So let's take a look at our magic. Active effects. Oh, we've got rock joint. Oh, okay. Less effective with we. Okay, so somehow we've picked up rock joint. So let's take a look at our items and our potions. And potion of cure disease. Okay, so we're going to use that. Which should remove that. Now that we can trans... So now we get another silver ore. So let's go back into here. We're going to need to pick up...
If not, let me know. I might have it. You look rather pale. Could be ataxia. So you're interested in the potion?
So, yes, we're going to need a potion of cure disease because we've, so we got one of those. Potion of health, minor healing, potion of Trustot. So there we go. Let's see if there's anything we'd want to sell. We're going to keep those. So, we're almost. So let's do a gold ore added. So we're slowly grinding. Well, while we're here, that was interesting. We dropped for a second. Go cast your magic someplace else. Okay. So let's see who's here. We can.
Life's hard enough with all these men propositioning me. That bard Mikhail is begging for a dagger up against his throat when he goes on about me. I heard him boasting at the Bannered Mare saying he'll conquer me as a true Nord conquers any harsh beast. If you want to try, go right ahead. I don't think anything will get through that thick skull of his, though. Remember, fresh fruit and vegetables at the end.
Silver ore. Actually, and then, you know, children are one of the things that you can't really hurt in Skyrim. You can't attack them, can't do things like that. So let's see here. So gold ore. So let's do smith. So we can make a gold ingot. Of course, two gold ore, and we have three. So now then, we've got one iron gold ingot. And this is, you know, this is sort of... just grinding, running back and forth. So we got silver ore. Now then, do we have anything that we need to get rid of? We've got amethyst. Leather. Steel ingots. So what's... Okay, so... So where are we at with magic? So let's go into the shop. More maidens. So let's.
Take a look.
So what do we want from him? So we've got value is 52. See, okay, so that's value is 52. So if we make Steel ingots. He's only going to give us 8. So that's the difference that we see from that. So, okay. Oh, but we can...
Blades, helmets, pretty much anything the suit needs.
But, what have we got here? So we got apparel. No, miscellaneous. I thought we'd made... So let's get out of here. So... We have a gold ore now. I thought we'd made some jewelry. So we're slowly grinding here. Use the tanning. This is... And we're going to make some leather. Okay, so we made some leather. And... Let's wait for a second. So we got alteration increased. Let's use the smelter. What can we make? We can make a gold ingot. Okay. So now then, can we then come down to jewelry and make a gold necklace? So yes, we can. So that gets us to 120 in value from the iron ore. So we can now recreate another gold ore, but it's going to take us a long time to grind, as you can see. Well, let's see what we got.
Gray mane or battle born.
What?
That stones in your ears. I asked what side you're on. Gray mane or battle born. New in town, huh? White Run's got 2 clans, both old and both respected. The difference is the Gray Manes turned their backs on the Empire, and we battle born stayed loyal. So I'll ask again, Gray Mane or Battleborn. Sooner or later, we all have to choose a side. More bad blood between the houses.
Okay, so we're going to probably pick up a quest here.
There's no reasoning with these people anymore. Long live the Empire.
Long live the Empire. Okay. So now we're going to come into the Drunken Huntsman and see if we can sell. Silver ore.
Ah, hello, Mike. Take a look.
So, let's see. What have we got here? So he doesn't want to buy, so we've made some jewelry. So he's not going to buy that. Okay, that's sort of a shame. We need to get higher up where you can get people to buy anything. We don't have enough magic. So... Let's see, how much does... First time I heard that, it was kind of interesting, but now it sort of gets tiring. So we're only getting 46 out of that, but it increases it every time we sell something. No. So let's see what has he got that's interesting. So... Silver ore, not worth that. Can always use a lockpick. What kind of potions does he have? Potion of cure disease. Minor potion of healing. Okay. So now then, we can come back and we can sell our gold necklace. He's still got 123, and we've only got 1,300. So we... So we keep going around. And... Interesting idea. So, all right. So when we craft it, when we craft, let's see, use the chopping block. So let's do a quick check to see where we're at, because we have some, if we craft some firewood, let's just craft a small amount of firewood. Then if we sell it, we can see what we get for the value of the firewood. So we've got two firewood. So we're gonna get, we get six firewood for each click, and then wading through all the animation. So that gives us six firewood. So if we come back into Bellathor's and we go to sell, oh, but Bellathor is closed for the evening. Ugh. Okay, one of the challenges is just the timing. Oh, now here, let's get to it.
Once I've made enough money trading with the fishing caravans, I'm going to buy the Bannered Mare from Holda. About the same as everyone else? They're the cat folk of Elsewhere. Great warriors, good traders. The way I hear it, Elsewhere ain't nothing like Skyrim.
So she's one of the characters that you can romance.
Sounds awful.
So.
Farewell.
So, now then, we can transmute some more. Got a silver ore. And do we have enough transmuted? Yes, we do. We can make a gold ingot. So, this is rather boring, I admit, but we're just grinding. So, what we're doing is we transmute it to gold. And we come back here, make a gold necklace. Yes. And it, but we're increasing our smithing significantly. So, we've got there. Now then, while we're... So we can now do another transmute, gold ore added. So we do have firewood, so that's the other thing we can do. We can make some steel arrows. So our smithing is now at 30, so we keep doing things like that, and we can now do another transmute. So we've got silver ore, and we're just waiting around a bit. So who else would buy our so we can, we could take a look at what's in these things, and you could search that. But we're just going to keep. So we have a gold ore. And actually, the other interesting thing you can do, since I'm sort of grinding, is if you come in and sell, each sale will...
Ah, hello.
So if we... Last time we sold 500 arrows at one bunch. But if we sell, we've got 417 steel arrows. So if I sell, this is the downside with that many. If I sell, say, 5 arrows, that counts as one transaction, which will increase my spellcraft. So I can sit around and keep selling. The downside is when you've got this many arrows, it takes a long time just to scroll. Now, there might be some faster ways with the keyboard, but I tend to just use my Xbox controller. And so we come down here, and this is a problem because it's going to take forever to sell them. So now then, actually the interesting one is if we sell the iron arrows, we can sell them one at a time, which isn't a problem because we only had two of them. So we sell our iron arrows. Oh, I think you hear our dog barking in the background. That's unusual because Zoe doesn't bark that often. Something must be going on. So let's sell another. See, we're only getting like one gold piece per arrow. So, but our rate of return, think about it, we were getting 8 for selling, if we sold a steel, if we sold something steel, so, okay.
Thank you very much for your business.
See, what we might as well, so if we sell something, and even if we back out, now, it's something to do while we're grinding, and this is just grinding. It takes a long time to do this. And it's the question is, do I really want to do that or do I want to go adventure some more? So let's see, what can I use in the smelter? Miscellaneous. Ah, I have two, I can make a gold ingot. So I got there. B. And we can use the blacksmith forge and make some more jewelry. Make another gold necklace. So we're crunching along. So now, does Lydia?
I'm right behind you. I am sworn to carry your burdens.
So what do I need? So, okay. So we leave her with what she's got. And so, let's, at this point in time, let's do one more transmute. Then I'm going to save the game. And I'm just going to call it quits for the evening because this is sort of boring. If you like these, this is interesting recording it. I've played Skyrim before, so that's why I know a little bit about this. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. I'd appreciate any comments, both positive and negative, about this. I'm having some fun. I'm doing some grinding. So if you like this, give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down and some comments. And there's a button for you to subscribe. So thank you.